Good morning, children. Myself Gurveen Kaur, Vice Chairperson of Sri Guru Nanak Dev Public School, Lambitab, Sri Muksar Sahib. I hope you people are enjoying yourself and you have resumed your studies also. Since Principal Ma'am has started the life processes for class 10, so I would also, being from the same faculty, from science background, I would also like to start another topic of life processes, that is transportation. I hope you will listen to me carefully, and I would like to ask you questions also after this. So let's start. As you people, all of you know that what is transportation? That's what is the transport, since you have been studying it from class first or even the lower classes. That's the means of transport was the things which carry you from point 1 to point 2. In human beings also, many things need to be transported from the body, from one part to another part, like food, then blood. For all these things, we have different organ systems. What is an organ? Organ is a group of tissues which is performing similar type of functions. In organ system, we have different organ systems in our body, like digestive system, excretory system, reproductive system, circulatory system. So that is called transportation system when we are talking about that system which transports the things from one part to another part. We have some vital organs in our body. What do you mean by a vital organ? Those organs which are most essential for our survival. Without them, we can't live. There are five type of vital organs in our body. For example, brain, that is the most important organ of our body. Then comes heart, then liver, then lungs, and then kidneys. We can live with one kidney also, but if we are not having two kidneys, so then with dialysis, it's very difficult to survive. Then we have some organs which are not so vital. Like we have eyes, we have our nose, these are also our organs. So some are vestigial organs. What are vestigial organs? Those organs which are, they are not present in our body, doesn't make any difference. Like vermiform appendix. These are the organs, if they are removed from our body, doesn't make much difference. Like gallbladder also. Like we have spleen also in our body. Okay, so for transportation, blood needs to be transported from one part to another because it transports food, oxygen and waste materials inside our body. What is blood? That is a connective tissue which is composed of two parts. Number one is plasma and number two is cells. What is plasma? That's a colorless fluid which is known as plasma. It's having many cells inside it. There are three types of cells in our body, that is WBCs, RBCs and platelets. WBCs means white blood corpuscles or cells, red blood cells and platelets. There are five main types of WBCs. These are the nucleated cells inside our body. The types of WBCs is neutrophils, lymphocytes, eosinophils, basophils and monocytes. They are all nucleated. Main function of this type of cells to fight the infection. Their number, normal number in a human body is 4000 to 10,000. This number increases if we are having any infection inside our body. They increase so that they can fight the infection and save our body. Second type of cell is RBCs. They are called red blood cells. Why they are red? They are red because of the presence of a red colored pigment which is known as hemoglobin. Okay, globin is a protein which is present inside it, and heme means iron, that is with iron, that the protein when it combines with oxygen also and it forms oxyhemoglobin. The main function of RBCs is to combine with oxygen to form oxyhemoglobin and then to carry this oxyhemoglobin throughout all the parts of your human body. The normal range of RBCs is different in males, females and in children. The normal value in males is from 4.7 to 6.1 millions. Then normal range in women is 4.2 to 5.4 millions per milliliter of the blood. And then comes platelets. These are the third type of the blood cells present inside our body, which helps in clotting of blood. It prevents the leakage of blood through capillaries. The normal range of this thing is from 1.5 lakhs to 4.5 lakhs per millimeter of the blood. Hemoglobin value is also different in males, females and children. In children, it's normally very much higher. For even say up to the age of 6 months, this value can be 14 to 19 of mm. Then in males, it's 12 to 14 and females is 11 or more than 11. Up to 13, it's normal value. So there is another type of tissue fluid which is known as lymph. What is lymph? That is basically when plasma, proteins and the other blood cells, they ooze out from the capillaries at the site of injury. Then that tissue fluid is known as lymph. It forms another circulatory system which is known as lymphatic system. Now we come to circulatory system in human beings. It basically consists of two main things. One is main pumping organ, that is called heart. And another are the vessels which carry this blood. There are three types of blood vessels inside our body. That is artery, vein and capillary. What is an artery? That is having very thick walls, because there is a reason for everything. When this is thick walled, because it has to carry the blood to the distant parts of the body. And with the more pressure, that's why this is thick walled. This is thin walled veins, because they don't have to cover much distance. Okay, then there are capillaries. When this is an artery, this is a vein. And when these things, they have to combine with the means of very fine vessels, these are called capillaries. That is the size. Now comes to the main organ, pumping organ, which is very vital for human being, that is called heart. Where does the children, you tell me, where does your heart lie? Where does your heart lie? Many people say that's in the left side of the heart. No, this is just in the center of your chest cavity, but its lower side is slightly tilted towards the left side. Okay, then it's the regarding location, many people can have some abnormalities also. Some people, they can have their heart towards the right side. Okay, the size of the human heart is of the size of your fist. This is your fist. How much the size of your fist is, that will be the size of your heart. That's a common this thing. Okay, there are two types of the things, systole and diastole. All the things, they work by contraction and relaxation. Whenever they have to carry anything inside their body, they have to relax. They have to give the space for the things to come inside it. When they have to leave anything out of it, then exit anything out of it, then it has to contract. Okay, so that is called systole and diastole. I'll tell you afterwards. Now come to the structure of human heart. Human heart is four-chambered heart. These are the four chambers of the human heart. This is the right side of the heart. This is the left side of the heart. Okay. So, okay. We'll come to this picture. This is the right side of the heart. This is the left side of the heart. Okay. This is called, upper two chambers are smaller in size. They are called atrium or auricle. What is it called? Atrium or auricle. This is the right side, this is the left side. So this is right atrium or auricle, and this is right ventricle, and this is left ventricle. Okay, left ventricle, right ventricle, right left auricle and right auricle. Okay, that is divided from each other by this is interauricular septum, this is interventricular septum. These are the cardiac muscles. This is a ellipse of heart. When we cut it open, it looks like this. Okay, just to show you all the structures. This is the vena cava. Pre-caval or post-caval also this is called. This is called vena cava also. This is the main vein of the body. It carries all the deoxygenated blood from all the parts which are situated above the level of your heart. Okay. Means it carries deoxygenated blood from your head, from your neck, from your shoulders. All the organs which are present above your level of your heart, That is, that deoxygenated blood is carried by superior vena cava and then it comes here in the right auricle. All the organs which are situated below the level of your heart, from right from the toes of your feet, from all the parts, that is carried by inferior vena cava and that is also poured over here. When we pour this, when our body pours this deoxygenated blood over here, then what happens? This is the auricle. It has to expand. When it expands, all this blood comes over here. This is filled by this. Okay? That happens up to, that is 0.1 second. In 0.1 second, that is filled. And this is called systolic rate. Your systolic pressure. Okay? When this is filled, there is a valve over here. This is a wall which is called tricuspid. What do you mean by tri means three, cuspid many leaf-like structures. Three leaf-like structures are there. That is a wall with the pressure of the, when it is filled with the pressure of this blood, this gets opened by the muscles which is known as caudi tendini. And this blood covers this part. Okay. When it comes to this part, this is closed. If it remains open, the same blood will go at the back. It will be a backflow of blood and it can cause troubles. Heart attack can occur. When this is filled, it has to receive blood. It has to expand. I told you earlier also, when anything is to be received, it has to expand, relax. When this is relaxing, this is called diastolic pressure. The pressure when it gets this thing, okay? So this thing is filled. When this is full, this is closed, this is full, then what will happen? It has to send the blood to somewhere else. This is pulmonary artery present inside this part. This valve is there, which is known as semilunar valves. Okay. It puts the pressure on these walls. The blood from this part, it goes to this part and then it reaches two sides of the lungs. Here, all the carbon dioxide which is dissolved in this deoxygenated or impure blood, that gets filtered over here. It combines with pure oxygen, fresh oxygen, and then it comes by means of this pulmonary vein, okay, to the right auricle. Sorry, to the left auricle, okay. When this is filled, it exerts pressure on this valve. This valve is known as mitral valve. Bicuspid valve. Okay. When this is filled, it puts pressure on this valve. This pure blood comes over this side. When this is filled, this is closed, this blood will go through this aortic arch or dorsal aorta. This carries the oxygenated blood to all the distant parts of the body by means of these small arteries. Smaller artery. This is the main aorta. That is how blood is getting pumped inside our body. I hope that's clear to you people. Okay. So I have not seen your books. So I don't know how much is needed for your level. You keep whatever that is according to your books. Okay. I hope the concept is clear to you. So now I think, what is the difference between arteries and veins? I've already told you that these are thick walled. Why? Because they have to tolerate more pressure. And then they have to distribute the blood to the distant parts of the body. Veins, they don't have to exert, they don't have to bear much pressure. So that's why they don't have to travel much also. That's why this is thin walled. All the veins, they carry deoxygenated blood. Exception is one, that is pulmonary vein. This is carrying oxygenated blood to the from the lungs to the heart. And then it carries all the arteries, almost they carry oxygenated blood. Okay. The exception is pulmonary artery, which carries the deoxygenated blood from the right side to the lungs. Okay. These are deep-seated arteries. Veins are superficial. Superficial means you can see these, all this green type of this thing, these are your veins. Arteries, there are four type of arteries which you can feel. One is here, another is on the temple side, one is on the ankle, you can feel, and one is on this side. Okay, these four arteries you can feel with your hands. in healthy, when this diastole and systole, this happens for 0.3 second. Okay, you know that our brain also gets tired when we do a lot of work, but our heart never gets tired, it never stops the function while we are alive. Why? Because for it works for 0.1 second, plus it works for 0.3 seconds, and then it goes for rest for 0.4 seconds after every work. Again, it works for 0.1 plus 0.3. Again, it rests for 0.4 seconds. That's why it never gets tired. Okay. In healthy human being, this only constitutes the heartbeat. Heartbeat is normal in a normal healthy adult. That is 72 times per minute. That means our in healthy human body, the heart beats for 72 times per minute. And our blood pressure, normal blood pressure is 120 mm of Hg, that is systolic pressure. And diastolic pressure is 80 mm of Hg. That constitutes blood pressure. If a human being is having more pressure, more blood pressure rather than 120-80, that is called hypertensive. The disease is called hypertension. That means in simple words, that person is suffering from high blood pressure. If that person's blood pressure is less than 120-80, then it means this is hypotension, that is low blood pressure. Okay, ji, I think this is clear to you. And now I would like to like that you people, you should study from your books. Online books are also available. NCERT books are available online also. That is Swayam portal is there. You can go. Since the shops are closed, you won't be able to get it from the shops. You can search, many people are getting it also. Otherwise, you can have a look at that Swayam portal and find your books and have a look at that. This is transportation in mammals. Thank you very much.